some people are born with abnormalities of their valves, may even be born with a murmur, those people are likely to need surveillance through their lives because those valves can deteriorate. Other people can acquire minor valve abnormalities. One instance would be due to endocarditis, and those people need ongoing surveillance during their lives. So those are givens. They should be following regular medical surveillance with their doctor and paying attention to their body. But how do we address someone who doesn't have any of those predispositions? Someone who's going along and doesn't know whether they have heart valve disease or not. Now that's a tough one. It's a tough one if their only symptom is, I'm tired all the time, but I've gained 20 pounds and I'm getting older. Because symptoms can change so slowly over time, tracking activity could be helpful. What did you do a year ago? Are you still able to do those things? Were you cleaning your own house a year ago? What sorts of activity has someone given up over time? Did you go out for a walk each evening and you've given that up? Were you walking through the grocery store? Are you riding a cart now? Generally, people don't give up those activities over the course of 1 or 2 years. If it's just because of aging, that happens over 10, 12, 14 years. The easiest thing to do is deny it or work it through. I think I'll go to the gym. That's what I need to do. I need to go back to the gym. And maybe you do, and that may work. Or it may work better if you go see your doctor first and get cleared to go back to the gym. And if people have facts, they're more likely to do the right thing. So what are the consequences of neglected valvular disease? It depends upon which valve it is, and it depends upon whether it's leaking or it's stuck shut. They present in different ways over the time, but the end of the road is always the same. And the end of the road is a failed heart muscle that's not going to recover. So the price of neglect too long is we can no longer fix it. Over the course of time, a heart that's beating twice the volume it needs to because the mitral valve's leaking everything back in, it gets thin, it gets dilated, it gets weak, and it stops squeezing. And now it's like this. We can't fix that. So end-stage heart failure is the last stop along the way. And the symptoms that people might be feeling as they take that train ride differ depending upon what valve they are. What might they be? Chest pain with exertion can be due to your valve. It doesn't have to be just due to your coronary arteries. Palpitations, flutterings, that feeling of somebody sucked my breath away inside my chest. The fatigue, profoundly out of proportion to your activities that day. The shortness of breath, the swelling of the ankles that go along with the heart failure that occurs over time. And heaven forbid, sometimes so little blood is being pumped forward that people start passing out, what we call syncope. What's the consequence of that? If you find yourself in that symptom complex, 50% of those people are going to be dead within 3 years. Symptom tracking, it just may save your life.